Okay guys, out early today. Today is Sunday and the day of what they call the Blue Claws Flea Market. So it's nice and early, the dealers are setting up. So I'm gonna take a quick run through before work and I'll let you know what I find. Talk to you soon.
The postcard guy back with my haul from the flea market this morning. Picked up some pretty neat things. It was a very well attended crowd there at the Blue Claws Flea Market. All kinds of neat stuff, old stuff, new stuff, all kinds of cool stuff. So I'll show you what I picked up today. These are Hallmark, like the Hallmark ornaments. These are called Kitty Car Classics. Large scale, some of these. These are pedal cars. Really nicely made, very detailed. Working parts, working steering. These were $4.99 each. I picked these up. They do not have the boxes, but they are all numbered. Looking these up on eBay, they look like they go about 30, 40 bucks a piece for the larger ones. What's neat is you have the large engine and then you have the little small one. This is an ornament. You can see the hook on it. The large ones were not. They're very, very heavy. Here's the large, heavy car, another year pedal car, again with working mechanisms, pedals, and then the matching small one. And then another small little ornament. So those are pretty neat. These are all Hallmark, marked underneath, and Kitty Car Classics. So that was a good buy. This is a nice blue early plate from Asbury Park, New Jersey. It says Views of Asbury Park and shows the old arcade, the Ocean Grove Auditorium, the fishing pier, the casino, Deal Lake, and the boardwalk. A nice early plate made for an Asbury Park store. It's got quite a bit of age to it. I did pay $15 for this. I think I can get about $25, maybe more, for the right collector. It's really nice collectible. These little dishes, I bought a pair of these. They appear to be military. They have Germany, Hawaiian Islands, Fort Lewis, Fort Bragg, England and France and Belgium. It looks like a bird of some type, maybe a vulture or an eagle with a spyglass riding on a bomb. So it's probably some kind of bomb unit for military, Central Europe, Rhinelands. They have a nice early stamp on the back. These were a whopping 25 cents a piece, so I couldn't pass those up. Any military like this is usually pretty good. I like this tin because of the graphics. Sahadi's Delicious Food and Halwa. I like that it had a New York City address, 195 Washington Street, New York City. Melts in your mouth. It has the pyramids and birds and all different kinds of things. Nice early tin. Got some age to it. This was $3. It was a very good buy. Usually don't buy Star Wars stuff, but this caught my eye. This is Jabba the Hutt with his spitting action and real feel skin. And also the two-headed announcer figure. It's new in the box. A little bit of wear on the box, but this was $5. So I think there's some money to be made there. That was a nice little buy. Anytime I see old media, I pick it up. This was a box of Sony 2HD formatted discs. This was a quarter at the flea market. Looks like the completeds are around $12 to $15, so good buy there as well. Over here, I'd like to pick up amusement park stuff. This is a Great Adventure Jackson, New Jersey glass. This is a little mug from a different dealer. I found one at one at another. This was 50 cents. The glass was 50 cents, and this was $2. This is another larger mug with all the amusements on it, and Great Adventure again, a New Jersey amusement park. So that was a nice find. Over here, I met a nice lady at the flea market who was selling some things, and these two patches caught my eye. Turns out that her husband was in the Korean War. He was a fighter pilot, and these are his patches off his bomber jacket. He passed away several years ago, and she was going through his stuff. She had just these two patches today, but she's going to see if she can dig out the photographs for me as well. The first patch is from around 1952. I found the similar patch with the date, with the same aircraft carrier on it. This was a fighter squadron that was on that aircraft carrier. This is the actual better patch. This is the Red Lightning, which was a fighter squadron. Again, around 53, 54, of which he was a member. They are real patches. They are not repros. These came right off his jacket. She assured me that she took them off herself. He wore these for many, many years on his bomber jacket. This patch here looks like it goes for about 25. From comps on this, it could go anywhere from 50 to 75, $85 for the one patch. Over here, this is a glass bunny, and I thought it was very cute. And then when I looked at it and just figured out what it is, it's actually a candy container. It has a rim inside where these would have little pellet candies inside, and then a cardboard closure on the bottom. It is marked from a Pennsylvania candy company on the bottom. These are very collectible in different shapes. There's cars, all different kinds of glass candy containers. And I really like this one. This was only $2 today. I thought that was a really good buy. Speaking of glassware and bottles, this is a Warner's Safe Cure. Same man that had the bunny had this Warner's Safe Cure. It's Warner's Safe Kidney and Liver Cure, and it has a picture of a safe on it. These come all different sizes and different color ambers. This one is a pretty nice color amber. It's going to clean up a little bit better. It's got some nice bubbles in the glass, nice early. These are $18.90s or so. This was $10. I think I got a really good buy on that. Over here, this is an early fruit jar lid. I like the shape. It's very, very early. Got a lot of blown glass bubbles in it. The name of the fruit jar is inside. The patent date is 1863, I believe. The green inside is actually in the glass. I thought that could be cleaned off, but it's actually blown into the glass. So I thought that was kind of unusual, and that was only a dollar. I did pick up a large stack of postcards and photographs. One of the things I really like to pick up are postcards and photographs. These are all period photos. This is a very early World War I era tank, which is kind of cool. This is a real photo postcard from England of a bunch of people by the lake. Looks like the kids are floating their pond boats on the lake. This is pulling a 1940s airplane out of a hangar. So it's World War II era. Kind of neat. It has all the descriptions on the back. This is a snapshot of Highlands, New Jersey, nearby where I live. This is inflating a French sausage, which I guess is some kind of balloon or Zeppelin type thing. But they're actually blowing it up. So again, that's probably World War I era, I believe. Nothing on the back, but they're pretty neat. This gentleman caught my eye, very snazzy here in his plaid pants, very proud of himself. I thought that was a neat photograph. And people like cat pictures and animal pictures. Here's a cat taking a peek out of a sink. Got all period things on the sink. And there's the kitty in the kitchen sink. And I think this is a DeSoto. A lot of times I see damaged auto photographs, so I guess they took these to show the damage from a car accident. But nice early car photograph. This also caught my eye. It's a little boy putting coins into a talking machine, Ask Grandma fortune-telling machine. Looks period, looks about right. Says Fortunes of Youth on the back. So it is a period photograph. I think people that like coin-op stuff and fortune teller stuff will really like these. All the photographs averaged about a dollar a piece. I think I got a really good buy on those. Over here, anytime I see handheld older games new in the box and unused, I pick them up. This was just $2. Looks like comps go for about $20, $25. This is Video Bridge, and it's new in the box. I actually picked up a bunch of these. They're all brand new, all sealed. These are Yo-Kai Watch. It's like a POG game, sort of like a Pokemon game. Don't know much about it, but it does look like they sell for about $10, $12 a piece. I only paid $1.99 each, and I think I got about six of those. Over here, this is a Foster's Beer Cozy. It's lined inside to put your beer in, keep it cold. I think I paid about $2 for that. Comps are about $8 or $10 on that. Over here, I like to find period 80s and 90s stuff. These are brand new, unopened Raggedy Ann and Andy napkins from, I believe, 1988. Over here, I picked up a bunch of these. These are Flintstones bath soap. And what's neat is they're still sealed. You got Quick Draw McGraw, Yogi Bear, the Flintstones, and Huckleberry Hound. And like I said, they're brand new, sealed, vintage. 1976, it looks like, 75 or 76, Hanna-Barbera products. And I did pick up a small little stack of these. And then one of my niche things I always look for at the flea market are exercise videos. They're nice bread and butter sales for me. I usually pick them up for $1 a piece. They sell on average $5.99, $7.99, sometimes more. As I was walking out of the flea market, I came across this box here. This is a brand new in the box headlight assembly for a 2010-2011 Toyota Camry. The man had $30 on the piece. It's new in the box with all its literature and paper. I offered him $20 and he took it. Looks like comps on eBay for brand new units like this to replace the headlight on your car go for about $125 to $150. So always look at used auto, not only used auto parts, but new auto parts. Like I said, this is a brand new headlight assembly, still in the cellophane, still in the wrapper, ready to go on somebody's car to make it complete. So that's about it for today. This is what I picked up at the flea market. This is about an average day for me. Always a nice mixture of things to find, new and old. If you like this video, please make sure you like and subscribe and stop back often to see what the postcard guy finds. Thanks, guys.